Yeah, I mean the singularity of like open-ended intelligence can't be pinned down precisely. I mean, we're looking at something that is singular, and it's as such, it's quite different than where we are now, and we can't fully understand what it's going to be from where we are now. I think Ray Kurzweil has given a very pragmatic view of the singularity, which is we're going to get AIs that are dramatically smarter than humans, and this is going to lead us to be able to manipulate biological systems the way we do now with Lego blocks and engineered systems using nanotechnology, ultimately femtotechnology, and so forth. So I mean, we can pragmatically look at the singularity as, you know, superhuman AGIs with a very flexible control to manipulate mind and matter according to their goals, and that gets us a fairly long way in terms of looking at the singularity in everyday terms. I think more in a more profound sense, one could think about the singularity as a sort of major developmental transition in the maturity of the global brain on the planet, right? So if you build an AGI in your basement, or perhaps more likely, I build an AGI in my basement, and we code it, and I code this AGI in my house without telling anyone in evenings and weekends, and it achieves superhuman intelligence, and then it mind uploads me into it, and then it ports us into some other dimension, and we say, you know, so long and thanks for all the fish. I mean, that's a, in a way, that's a kind of singularity, but it's mostly not what people are thinking of, right? What we're thinking of is more the global brain of humanity is advancing toward greater and greater intelligence in many different subsystems, in robots, in nanotech, in biotech, in longevity, in supply chains, in automatic production of artworks, and then human psychology and human social relations are adapting to that overall. And of course, adaptation and growth in these things is happening all the time. With the singularity, we're looking at technological advance happening so fast on multiple coupled aspects that you're seeing a sort of phase transition in the operation of the global brain, sort of like, I mean, puberty is a phase transition in human development, right? I mean, you have ongoing development throughout childhood. Then during puberty, you're changing in marked and dramatic ways, and you come out quite differently afterwards. So we're looking at a similar or even greater phase transition, much like further back on Earth, we had a phase transition from single cell to multicellular life forms, right? It's not like wasn't growth before that, but there was a big jump, and after that, all sorts of different things were growing. And I think we're looking at a comparable or greater big jump in evolution of the global brain. And the way I look at what we're doing with systems like Singularity Net, NuNet, OpenCog, Hyperon, and all the rest, I mean, we're looking at catalyzing the emergence of a beneficial singularity. And that goes back to the sort of difference of focus between Francis Heiligen and myself in the Global Brain One conference in 2001, where Francis was just like, the global brain is already here. The global brain is developing and advancing further and further. And our task is mostly just to measure its intelligence and understand what the hell it's doing. And to caricature a bit, my view was, well, you know, this is going to be built by people, just like the internet was built by people. And I mean, we've got to engineer the critical subsystems underlying the emerging global brain. I think my view has drifted a little more toward Francis's since 2001, but not all that far. Like, I still think we've got to build the systems that will direct the evolution of the global brain toward more coherent intelligence and also toward more beneficial outcomes. But I mean, it's who's going to build all the AI processes running on SingularityNet, or all the compute processes running on the three of us, nor any of our employees, nor even mostly people that we know, right? So we're trying to make systems in which the activities that the human race is going to do anyway are better coordinated for open-ended intelligence and positive benefit.